The official interest rate has been kept on hold at 4.1%, the first decision under new Reserve Bank Governor Michelle Bullock. It's a welcome reprieve for borrowers, but today a warning, it may not be for long.
An early start on a big day for the new RBA Governor, but Michelle Bullock was giving little away.
How are you feeling ahead of your first meeting in charge?
Oh, fine, thanks.
Anything further on that?
No, have a nice day. Thank you.
Should Australians prepare themselves for any further interest rate rises?
No, thanks. No comment, thanks.
Ultimately, today's decision was to do nothing, leaving rates on hold, waiting to see how previous rate rises continue to impact the economy and household budgets. Inflation might have passed its peak, with some prices easing, but fuel continues to surge and rents remain too high. The RBA now waiting for quarterly inflation figures out at the end of the month and wages data mid-next month.
Those two data points are going to be really critical to see whether the Reserve Bank needs to raise interest rates again before the end of the year.
The official cash rate might now have been on hold since July, but lenders, it seems, are cashing in. Research by Canstar shows almost half the lenders on its books have lifted their variable interest rates in the past few months by an average 0.15%, and fixed rates have been going up too.
Some of the larger lenders have also stopped competing for those wanting to refinance.
Do not let that turn you off. There are over 100 different lenders in the market. Some smaller banks may be just prepared to offer you a crack in order to get your home loan on their books.
And if your bank won't haggle, others will, a number offering rates below 5.75%. Eddie Meyer, Nine News.
Let's bring in Nine's finance editor, Chris Kohler. Chris, is a hike what mortgage holders will see next?
Well, Pete, that is unfortunately looking increasingly likely. The market is now pricing a 20% chance of an interest rate hike next month when the RBA meets on Melbourne Cup Day, and forecasts for interest rate cuts are now being pushed further back. Economists used to think that we could see that happen in February, then they shifted to May, and now the consensus is for August. So it does keep on creeping deeper into 2024. Now, as we heard there, quarterly inflation figures, they're going to be the key. We'll see those on October 25. So that is now a huge day on the economics calendar, Pete.
Chris, thank you.